Joining us now, retired NASA astronaut Leland Melvin, who flew with Wilmore in 2019 and was part of Williams' astronaut class in 1998. Great to see you, Leland. How are you?
Jose, great to be here. And Suni is a huge animal lover, so those dolphins just channeled her and brought her back home safely.
How'd you see the mission yesterday? It was fascinating to watch.
Yeah, it was beautiful. I mean, everything worked just perfectly. The drogue, the mains landed, got them out, and they were smiling and happy and feeling great.
So you know both Butch and Suni personally. How do you think they handled these unexpected months in space?
Well, you know, they weren't stranded because we trained for the contingencies, the issues, the drama. And they had gloves taken up there for them to stay longer. The Boeing Starliner was a test flight. So anytime you have a test flight, you have to have contingencies in case something doesn't work right. So they're military officers. They've been in war. They've been trained to be able to do these things. And so stranded was not an issue. They were loving life because one of the things is they have so many more hours in space now. I mean, Suni has 608 hours a second, longest person in space in days, and she's behind my commander Peggy Whitson for 675 days in space. So they're fine.
Hey, you know, I flew on that NASA gravity airplane many years ago. Did I think 48 parabolas, and that stuff affects you. What kind of an impact do you think long term living in space has on humans?
Well, long term space flight gives you many different things, but you know, your DNA can be severed by solar radiation. Your vestibular system changes, your bone density changes, and we have countermeasures to try to look at all of these things. Intracranial pressure pushes on your eyeballs, and if you don't wear glasses when you launch, you may be wearing glasses in space. So these are all things that we as astronauts, we are guinea pigs to see what are the things that we need to solve before we go live on the moon and Mars one day.
What do you think about going back to the moon, and do you think that we will live to see humans on Mars hanging out like that pod of dolphins, but the pod of humans waiting for others to arrive in Mars?
Well, you know, hopefully there is not a pod of dolphins up there waiting for us. Maybe it's something else up there. But I think, you know, we as human beings, we are curious, we are explorers. And so whether that's going to the moon or Mars or deeper in our cosmos is something that is intrinsically installed in us, in our DNA. And we must do that, Jose, or we're going to falter as a civilization. So that's why we explore. That's why we do these things that are hard so that we can make life easier, whatever planet that we're living on.